Hello, welcome everybody to our webinar. Today we are going to present our global monitoring solution for gas insulated switchgear. My name is Marco Piga. I'm CSR manager at Techim Paltanova Group. I'm expert in global monitoring system. I'm connected from Bologna, Italy. After a quick introduction about Paltanova Group, we will have five different sections. Why monitoring of high voltage gas insulated switchgear, circuit breaker monitoring, partial discharge, SF6 monitoring, and a fully integrated HMI. Nowadays, Paltanova Group is formed by three different companies with a long experience in condition assessment technologies. These companies are ISA, Techim, and IntelliSo. We can provide solution covering medium voltage and high voltage applications as reported in the example here below. You have a current transformer, voltage transformer application, and solution for transformer, medium voltage, high voltage cable, surge arrestor, substation application, GIS, rotating machines, motors, switchgear, medium voltage switchgear relays, and overhead power line. As you can see here in these three pictures, we have three headquarters. Two are located in Italy, one in Taino, not so far from Milan, another one in Bologna, and the third one in the USA, in Massachusetts, in Andover. We have also eight regional offices, are located in France, in Germany, in the Emirates, India, Singapore, another one in USA, Panama, and Brazil. We have also almost 100 distributors. So you have here the link. So you can check your local distributor in your region, in your country. We have internally three crew for service as service provider, are located in Italy, in Germany, USA, and even in India. And we have, for each headquarter, even the R&D department for the competence, relative competence for online and offline solution. Nowadays, Paltanova Group is composed by almost 130, 140 employees. Regarding Paltanova solution for GIS, we have, as you can see, let me switch on the pointer, a testing instrument for offline test, partial discharge portable unit for both offline and online test, and the topic today, the integrated global monitoring system. You have here another link. You can download our last technical guide regarding GIS monitoring. So we can start looking to the first question: why monitoring of high voltage GIS? We know that GIS is composed by several subsystems like circuit breaker, instrument transformer, disconnector, earthing switch, bus part, and a lot of other minor electrical mechanical components. Well, why monitoring of GIS is so important? We will try to discover it in the next slides. Now I would like to discuss about GIS reliability and failures. GIS have, as you can see, attained a very high degree of reliability and availability. Nevertheless, failures, even in this case, cannot be totally excluded, and shown by service experience and statistics. Besides manufacturing problems, the fact may be induced during transportation, installation, or through the aging process. And such defects should be found as early as possible in order to avoid outages. Here a graphic representation of the major components in a gas insulated switchgear, starting from the LCC, so the local control cubicle, where we have the controlling part of the GIS and the natural link to the substation. We have the spring mechanism, is shown here in the second picture, the circuit breaker part, cable termination, bus bar, current and voltage transformer, and disconnecting and earthing. Here on the right corner, you can see the failure statistics according to the SIGRE working group A3.06, 1.39, 0.18, both for current and voltage transformer, 1.84 for disconnecting earthing. These are the failures per 1,000 circuit break bay per year. And if we calculate the cumulative failure, we reach 0.75% of the failure per year. This is not a huge number compared with other asset types. But if we consider an expected lifetime of 40 years for a substation with GIS, and with, for example, 20 bays, we can expect more than 20 failures during the lifetime of the GIS. Looking here to the types of the failure modes, we can recap all failures for major and minor components in four different categories. We have the insulation failure with a 57% of probability. Then we have mechanical failures with 18% of probability. Then 13, the third category for the gas leakage, SF6 gas leak, plus an additional 12% for other causes. On the right, we have seen the same statistic in the slide before. You have 0.75% of the failure per year, calculated from the entire population of more than 1,000 bays with the age less than 15 years old. This statistics is in the report of the second international survey of high voltage GIS service experience, thanks to SIGRE working group. And as you can see here in the graph, we have on the vertical axis the failure rate, and on the horizontal axis the age. We have an average of 0.75 here, up to 15 years. But where we move from 20, 25, and almost 30 years old GIS, the failure probability increase up to 5%. Now, how we can mitigate the risk of the failure? We have basically two main strategies. From one side, we can reduce the impact of the failure on the business value, or on the other side, increasing the mean time between failure. Again, on the left, what we can do is, for example, increase the GIS redundancy using, for example, a double bus bar system. And if we want to increase the mean time between failure or reduce the failure risk, we can perform diagnosis and monitoring to reveal critical failure mode in GIS. We have also some disadvantages. For example, if we want to using a double bus bar system, we have an increased cost of the GIS installation and even the complexity. And on the right, if we want to use monitoring strategies, the challenge in this case is to select a cost-effective approach, omitting overlapping methods. There are several methods. There are optical methods. There are mechanical methods. There are a lot of at least 10 different methods. We have to choose the right mix of approach. And today we are focusing on selecting the right monitoring strategy to ensure the highest GIS reliability. And regarding this last point, the GISNOVA news is that the many of the causes of the failures in the GIS, both mechanical or the electrical, failures can be largely within the operator control. A complete monitoring system based on partial discharge, SF6, and circuit breaker analysis and monitoring avoids the most part of the GIS failures due to basically to lack of maintenance, aging, and again, electrical failure or overloading, for example. If you remember the pie we've seen before with the failure statistic, with 57% of the installation failure, 18, 13, and 12. With this approach, we can cover more than 80% of the incoming failures. And last but not the least, even a complete monitoring system helps the GIS operators to increase profitability, reliability in general, and even the safety of the GIS fleet. And this is exactly what we have to achieve even with our global monitoring system. In this slide, you can see the list of the parameters that we can be monitored by our system. That's in this webinar, we decided to call it GISNOVA. GISNOVA is a modular and configurable monitoring system that can be also be combined with according to the customer requirements. We can start discussing about circuit breaker monitoring. Breaker mechanism failure is one of the major cases of GIS failures. Online monitoring of mechanical and electrical parameter in the circuit breaker prevents such failures. And let me say that in addition with the circuit breaker monitoring, GISNOVA can monitor also the earthing switch and disconnector, more or less with the same approach, in order to increase the reliability and the safety for the entire GIS. Then we have another model. This is for partial discharge monitoring, where incipient faults into GIS, such as, for example, loose connections, voids, metallic particles, protrusion, can be taken under control. The last model is a SF6 leakage monitoring. That through this model, we can provide a real-time SF6 leakage monitoring and reporting, and we can help utilities to prevent failures due to the SF6 leakage, for example, and we can also help the customer to comply with environmental regulations.